a rebellious teenager, not wanting to listen to its mother. Well, hey friends, it's Mandy with Sweetly Home, and today I have a bit of a different video for you. I hope you enjoy it. So I often get some really kind and sweet compliments on my makeup. And I gotta tell ya, for a girl who's wrestled with insecurity about her look most of her life, those compliments mean the world to me, so thank you. And recently I've also got a few questions about different products that I wear, so I thought I would just film a video of some of my all-time favorite makeup products and the things that I wear pretty much every single time I do my makeup. So this is a mix of mostly drugstore items, a couple high-end things. Now, I have to be honest, I did not get my first high-end makeup purchases until last year. I will be 35 next month, and just that means for as long as I've been doing makeup, since I was like 11, 12 years old, I've always used drugstore items. I'm going to share with you some of my favorites. Okay, so we are going to start with the base. We're gonna just, gonna kind of go through like kind of how I do like my makeup. And the one thing that I always use is a primer. I have very oily skin. It's very problematic. I have large pores. I have redness. I have scarring. I have fine lines. I mean, I have ugly skin, which is why I wear makeup a lot, just to hide the ugly. So I have to start with a really good primer because I need something for my makeup to stick to and to hold all day, because as oily skin girls know, your oils will just seep through your makeup and make it look like a hot dang mess, and we don't want that. So just this past Thanksgiving, we went to the mall, to Sephora, for Black Friday. Yeah, Black Friday. And I ended up getting a sampler pack of Smashbox primer. And I fell in love with the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer Water. It also came with just the regular kind of like silicone-y Smashbox primer, and I do really enjoy that. However, in the winter, I'm actually really loving the extra hydration that this gives. Even though I have oily skin, our water is hard, and just with the extra dryness of the winter, my skin is quite parched. So I have been absolutely loving this product. I can put it on in the morning, and by the end of the night, and I'm talking like 11, 12 o'clock at night, my makeup still looks like I had just applied it. It looks that good, and I attribute all to this Smashbox primer. Now, I'm not really gonna talk about foundation because I haven't found a foundation that I absolutely love yet. I have been using the Revlon Color Studio foundation, and I enjoy it, I like it, but it's, I'm using the normal to dry right now, again, because my skin is a little more on the dry side because of the winter, and it just isn't, I feel like I have to apply way too much to get the coverage I want. I really want to invest in Estee Lauder Double Wear, but until I can actually go to a place where I can be color matched, I'm not attempting that. So I am using Revlon ColorStay. It's good, and I'll probably buy it again once I'm done with the bottle that I'm using now. So again, for concealer, I had been using the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer, and I went through several tubes of that, and I do like it, but as I grow older, and as I go further into mom life, I have developed really, really, really dark circles under my eyes, and the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer, while it camouflages really well, like down in this area, and brightens, and covers, it does not cover my dark circles near enough. It's very sheer kind of right under my eyes, so I really want to invest in the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer, and I have a feeling I'm going to be over the moon about it once I finally am able to get my hands on a tube of that. So what I have been using for concealer is something a little bit different, but if you have watched any of my recent vlogs or any of my recent videos, this is what I have been using for concealer. And this is the Urban Decay All Nighter Foundation. This is my first high-end foundation purchase, and it was actually free to me. My mother-in-law, with one of our local drugstores, if you're in Canada, at Shoppers Drug Mart, she collects points with their like loyalty card, and she gets free makeup, like almost $200 worth of free makeup in the drugstore, and they carry high-end brands. So one of our local Shoppers has Urban Decay, and there's other high-end brands as well, but the Urban Decay foundation, the All Nighter foundation, had just come out, and so I was anxious to try it, so I got a bottle. Initial application, it's beautiful. It's flawless. It looks amazing, but this oxidizes to the point where I look like a banana. And I looked at some of the footage from my videos, like, kind of in the summer, and I'm like, whoa, that looks terrible. So I actually started using this as a concealer recently because I was out of my Maybelline Fit Me, and it is gorgeous, and it doesn't oxidize. I mean, if it does oxidize, honestly, you can't tell because it's sitting on top of your foundation and then it's under my powder, and it just looks flawless and beautiful. I am kind of at the very, I'm at the very tail end, and the nice thing is that you can unscrew the top and you can kind of get the very last bits out of this bottle. The other really awesome thing about this is that a little, like, one pump is supposed to do your entire face, so you just need a teeny tiny bit for concealer. So that's what I'm using right now. Next is powder. So this technique I learned from Makeup Geek. She shared how she does her full face of foundation one time, and this is how she powdered her face, and light bulbs kind of went off for me because I was like, wow, that's kind of what I'm doing. I'm going to do more of what she's doing, because her skin always looks flawless. So I have the Maybelline Fit Me powder, and this is in the Set and Smooth, and this is normal to dry. I also use, the oily one. However, again, with the winter, I've been using the normal to dry because it actually gives a bit of, I don't want to say shimmer, I can't think of the word. It just gives some luminosity, I think, to my powder setting. I mean, you can kind of see right here. It just, it sparkles a bit, not sparkles in it as in glitter, but it gives some life to my face and isn't as totally matte as the oily. So what I do is, and I don't have the little powder brush, but I just use the powder compact that comes with it, the little powder pad, and I press, like press it into my skin. I don't wipe, I press it, and it just creates a flawless finish. Like I said, I have awful skin. If you've ever seen any of my vlogs where I have been barefaced, you probably see it. Like, awful, awful, awful skin. Like, scarring and large pores, and it's just, it is what it is. But this powder makes my skin look like porcelain, and I love it. So I do my whole face in it. I set my foundation, and I set the concealer, and there you have it. And it, my makeup lasts all day long. I do not have to worry about my oils breaking through, and I can wear my makeup. I tend to get ready around 6:30 in the morning, and I go all the way until 11:30, 12 o'clock at night, and it looks flawless all day long. So because I use a full coverage foundation, I like to actually use a beauty sponge to apply my makeup because the beauty sponge actually kind of soaks up some of the product and you're left with just a beautiful finish of foundation, but you're not left with cakey foundation, which is what I love. I can't use a brush. I've tried using various brushes and it just feels like I'm just spreading product all over my face and it feels like there's too much of it. So for probably about 2 years, I've been using the Beauty Blender and I really, really loved it. But recently, again, when I was home visiting my family for Thanksgiving, I found the Real Technique sponge at Walmart. The Beauty Blender, I think in Canada, is between $20 and $24. The Real Technique sponge, when I picked it up in the States, was between $5 and $6. So this is my Real Technique sponge. It needs washed. Real life here. I just did my makeup. And I love this. I love this. I have only touched my Beauty Blender, I think, twice since I started using this, and it was just because this was too makeup-y to use. I love it. So what I do is I pump some foundation on my hand, and then I use this flat part, and I pick up a bit of product, and then I just tap it into my skin. And I usually end up doing two layers of foundation, because again, this shears out your foundation and it absorbs a lot of the product, so you aren't getting a lot of cake face. Real Techniques, love it. Okay, so when it comes to bronzer, I like to have some bronzer on my face, and I have been dying to try this product. Got it when I was home for Thanksgiving, because here it retails between $20 and $23. Usually I can find it like $22. But I found this for like $6 or $7 at Walmart, and it is the Physician's Formula. Is it Physician's Formula? Yes, Physician's Formula Butter Bronzer. This is raved about by like a lot of beauty YouTubers. They rave about this. And my girl, Jaclyn Hill, I love Jaclyn Hill. She's who like pretty much taught me all of this. I've been watching that girl for, I don't know, since she had 60,000 some subscribers. This was like 4 or 5 years ago. And now she's at almost 4 million. I've watched every one of her videos. I love her. But she raves about this product. And the awesome thing is it smells like coconut and the beach and suntan oil and lotion. And it's so good. And it provides such a really beautiful, natural color. And I'm wearing it today. Pretty much all these products I'm wearing today, because it's what I wear. It's just what I wear. I'm not somebody who has a ton of makeup. I have what I have. I love what I love. And that's what I stick to. And I just switch it up with different eyeliners, a couple different blushes, and eyeshadows. Other than that, it's the same exact products. Okay, so let's talk eyeshadow. I purchased these eyeshadow palettes almost 3 years ago, I think. I'm going strong still on them, and they are what I do 99% of all of my eye looks with these two palettes. I'm looking to get another one or two of this brand, and it is Morphe. I will not buy another high-end eyeshadow because I love these eyeshadows so much. I'm not a beauty guru. I am not going out to the club. I am not in front of the cameras except this. I am not working with like fashion brands and like all the things. I'm married. I'm a stay-at-home mom. I don't need a whole lot of eyeshadow products. I mean, and other makeup products in general. Love to watch beauty videos, but I just, that stuff, I don't need it. And I found what works for me, and I love the quality of these shadows. I've spent $20 for each of these palettes, and I had a coupon code too. And I use them like crazy. So let me show you what ones I have. So I have the 35E, and I mean, the top is broken off. But you can see how much I have used this palette. A couple of them I lost the pans. I have them in my makeup. And some of them my son got into and kind of broke. But for the most part, like, I have hit pan on a lot of these shadows. I like to use like this to do in my as a transition color, like right here. And then this top row. Okay, so I mentioned my gal Jaclyn. So I don't have the money to drop like $50 on a highlighter. I would love to, like, hear me, I would love to. However, there's other things to spend my money on, and that is not one of them, the highlighter. So I used the top row of these shadows. As you can see, like this one, there's hardly anything left, and same with this one. So what I do is I use this brush, and this is from Sigma. It is the tapered highlighter F35, and I just drag my brush through the top of these, and I get some product, and then I on my temples a little bit, and then do the same, load it up, and I blow it off. Add a little right here, just to give some definition, because I kind of mat out my face with my powder, and that is what I do. I use this eyeshadow. Well, Jaclyn mentioned this palette and these shadows as one of her top highlighters for 2016, and if you know anything about Jaclyn, she created a highlighter, Champagne Pop, so the girl knows what she's talking about, and I just was like, I feel so validated right now. So then the other palette I have is the 35U. I don't use this one quite as much. I don't use a lot of these shadows in here. I'll use sometimes the gold one, occasionally some of these right here. I love this row. I use this row a lot. This one I've used quite a bit. And again, this one I use a lot for my transition color. So even if I'm doing like a look with something like this, I have used probably this or this or this as a transition color to give my shadow something to kind of cling to. And then I use these two as, let me use a different one. underneath my line, my eye, to do eyeliner. So, anyways, I love this color right here. They're beautiful. They're beautiful, beautiful shadows, and I love them. Okay, so let's talk brushes. So I have some brushes that I use, and they changed the game for me when it came to my makeup application with my eye looks. Again, back to Jaclyn, because I love her. She had a collection with Sigma, and I got some of those brushes, and I love them. So the names have worn off. I don't know. I will list everything down in the description box. But so this brush is the one I use for my transition. And so what I do is I dip my brush in that like orangey color, and then I start in the corner and I do circles and I do windshields and I just put that color on. A nice pretty wash with this brush. It's a beautiful like blending type brush. And then I will use other brushes, like whatever I have, to put on more color. And then I will use this brush. So this is a natural hair brush. This is a blending brush. It's an E25. And between every color that I do, I use this to go back and forth and to brush away any harsh lines. Blending is the key to eyeshadow that looks nice. It just, harsh lines are brutal. Like if you've got, you need to blend. So this is the most awesome blending brush. You just, and then in between every shadow that you do, you just use this and you're good to go. And then the other brush that I have is the Morphe S21. Now, I picked this up when I bought my palettes, and this was on clearance. It was like $1 or $2, and it's kind of got this dome shape here, and I use this to pack on color. And I really like this brush. And the last brush that I have, I do not have a name for it. I bought it in a pack of like 20 brushes. I'll see if I can share. It's kind of, it's thin and it's tapered, and I use it for adding my highlight right here. And for my highlight, I use NYX Nude. It's ESO3, and this makes an eye look for me. So if I ever forget this, it looks off. It's kind of the color of skin, and so it just, I don't know what it does. I don't know, but it makes it look good. So that. And then actually after I put this on, which is the last makeup product that I put on my eyes, I go back in with this blending brush and I will just kind of brush and make sure that in between the highlight and my eyeshadow, there are no harsh lines. Okay, so let's talk eyeliner. I have three different types that I use, two that I normally always use. The one I ran out of a long time ago, and as soon as I order from Sephora, I will order another pot of this. So I'll just tell you what it is. It's Bare Minerals, it's coffee bean, and it's a liner shadow. And so what I do with this is I have like a really, I don't have it with me, a tiny little brush, and I just put it on my lid just like I would eyeliner. It's a powder. It's very, 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 very pigmented, and there's a lot of fallout if you're not careful. But it is the kind of thing that will give you a really pretty smoky eye if you just kind of blend out the lines of it. And it is so quick for a 3-minute eye. Like, you can put this on and some mascara and you have a really pretty eye look. It looks like you have eyeliner, it looks like you have a bit of shadow, it looks like you put in some effort and it like was 3 minutes. This stuff is awesome. So next, this is what I use for most of my eye looks. because I'm wearing liquid eyeliner right now because I'm out of this. It's down to the nubbins, and I need to get another one. This is Essence Longlasting Eye Pencil in number 2, Hot Chocolate. This color is the bomb.com. It is so rich, and this thing is so super creamy, and it's $2.99. Again, I'm in Canada. It might be cheaper if you are in the States, but $2.99, and this eyeliner, I will not purchase anything else. This is on par with some of the eyeliners that I've used, like from Revlon and Loreal. This is amazing. I will not go back to those other brands. In fact, when I went to go purchase another eyeliner, the store I was at did not carry Essence, and I didn't get another one. Amazing product. So the other eyeliner that I've been using is the Essence Eyeliner pen, and it's waterproof, and this is in black, and that's what I have on today. It is a hard, let's see here, it's a hard liner. It's hard felt tip, I guess I should say. Very, very pigmented, very easy to use, and incredibly long lasting. Again, all this stuff lasts me all day long. That's the beauty of it, is I've kind of worked through so many different products that I found the things that really, really work really well for me. So for my highlight, the brush that I use is a Sigma tapered highlighter. It is the F35. I don't know if I mentioned that, but feels so good. Okay, we're getting down to the end, y'all. Okay, two more eyeshadow products. So if I'm gonna do like a pink eye and I want a bit of a pop, I will add some of this Loreal Infallible iridescent finish eyeshadow stuff. So this is what it looks like. This is in the color Forever Pink, and I think there's a lot of really beautiful pots of these that L'Oreal carries. So I just use a finger, usually kind of like my ring finger, and I rub it into the product. Don't use a brush because it will not work. And then I just kind of put it on top of my eyeshadow to give a pop. Okay, so for the other eyeshadow that I really love, and again, it kind of does the same thing as the L'Oreal one, is this Lise Watier in Wonderland, and it's an Ombre Souffle. It is gorgeous. It's gold. It's so pretty. So pretty. It looks like you dipped your eyes in gold. It is so pretty. I'm wearing it today. So now let's talk mascara. Woo! Okay, so prior to having kids, I had nice eyelashes. Like, They were long, they were thick, they were full and beautiful, and I constantly, the number one question anyone ever asked me was, are you wearing fake eyelashes? Are you wearing fake eyelashes? I would get this from people at like the gas station, like the man pumping my gas at the gas station. I would get it from waitresses. I would get it from people that like I was like checking me out at Walmart or whatever. All the time. It was the question I got asked. No one asks me that anymore, and it's because I had kids and my eyelashes got brittle and thin and skimpy and wimpy and terrible. I would love, 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 love to get eyelash extensions. But that's a lot of money, and it's kind of frivolous in my position to do that. I would love it though, if I had the extra money. However, I can't justify the purchase right now. I have never worn false eyelashes. I tried on my wedding to wear like individual false eyelashes. I had no idea how lame and hard that would be, it didn't work. So I've never worn false eyelashes. And recently, in recent years, I have thought about actually starting to wear false lashes because my lashes are so thin anymore. So when my mother-in-law took me to get, to use some of her Shoppers Drug Mart points with her, and I decided to get the Urban Decay Subversion Eyelash Primer. It's just a white mascara, basically, and it's a primer for your lashes. I'm on the tail end of this. I'm like digging to get it out because it's not cheap. But this stuff is incredible. When I first started using this, my lashes looked, I'm not kidding, like at least 25% longer. I would say 50%, but that's really stretching it. They felt 50% longer. They looked full and long and thick and beautiful. And I was so thankful and happy. I'm saving up to go get more of this product because it's amazing. And to go along with that, I ended up getting the Urban Decay Perversion Mascara. I have tried all the drugstore mascaras, all of them. I have gone through them all. I have found a few favorites and a few ride or dies. Nothing compares, nothing to this combo right here. Nothing compares to you. When I would do my eyelashes, before I ever found these and before I had brittle lashes, I wore three mascaras. So I'd wear one on the bottom as sort of a primer, and then I would wear one next to kind of fan out my lashes and make them look pretty and long and just to be the pretty factor. And then I follow up with L'Oreal Voluminous. This is my ride or die. I've probably been through like 30 tubes of this, maybe more. This is always the last step when it comes to mascara for me, no matter what. This makes my lashes look full, it makes them thick, it makes them dark, it makes them beautiful. I can't wear this by itself. I don't know how people do it, I can't do it. I have to have other mascara underneath and this on top, and it makes my lashes what it is. So this right here is my combo currently and has been since, I don't know, maybe August or so. And I love this. However, these mascaras are way too thick for my bottom lashes. So at the same time, my sister-in-law gave me a sample of Benefit Roller Lash. And this is a beautiful mascara, and I'm still using the sample. I'm still getting the very last little bits out of it. But this is what the brush looks like. It's a little bit curved, and it's kind of one of those like nylon bristle brushes, but it goes right up close to your root and combs your lashes down, and is not clumpy. So with a mascara like this, you can get clump action like crazy. So I really prefer this for my bottom lashes. The beauty is I got all three of these high-end products for free. It's gonna stink when I have to go repurchase them because I'm pretty much on the end, but worth every penny to me. So teenage hair. I mentioned in one of my vlogs, one of my lip colors that I always wear, I kind of go through like maybe just like 3 or 4 lip glosses. I am not a lipstick. I used to love to wear lipstick. Haven't really worn lipstick in a while. Oh, see this teenage rebellion here. Ugh. I found a liquid lipstick though that I love. Okay. No, we're talking about the vlog. Okay. So in the vlog, I mentioned one of my favorite lip glosses, and it is from Milani, and it's called Pink Lady. I can't find it. I can't find it to bring it here on camera. So just trust me that Milani lip glosses are some of my favorite. I love the formula. It's super long wearing. It is, I don't know if you call it sticky. It might be a little bit sticky for some people. Personally, I think it feels beautiful on my lips, and it's so long wearing, and it makes my lips look beautiful. So Pink Lady. And then the other one is an essence color. And so this is a liquid lipstick, and it's what I'm wearing right now. The name is smudged off and there's nothing on the bottom. So I will tell you that if you go to your drugstore and you look at essence, this is, I think, the second tube of liquid lipstick from the left. So there's one shade that's a little bit more orangey than this, and then it's this color. And this is so beautiful. It's so beautiful. I need to get another one because I'm kind of at the tail end. But it's awesome. Again, this too is really long wearing. Long wearing, you're going to have it on for 3 hours. But it's going to last you a significant amount of time. And it's just going to look pretty. It feels so nice on my lips. I've had a few people ask me to do a get ready with me type video. I'm a little nervous to do that, to be perfectly honest, because my makeup is not for the every woman. It's not for every mom. It's not quick. And it's not, I like to do my makeup. So I sit with my kids in the living room and I put my makeup on while they're playing or watching a show or whatever. Makeup for me is my me time, so it's not fast. I have no such thing as a 5-minute face. None at all. No such thing. And so I fear in trying to do a get ready with me or even, here's how I do my foundation or whatever, that people would look at it and they would say, I can't do that. Well, you put too much foundation on your face for me and that kind of thing. So again, it's full coverage stuff. It's full coverage. So I don't know. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. Thanks for sticking with me to the end. It's so long. I don't know what I'm going to cut out to make it shorter. This rambling. Okay. I will talk to you guys later. Give me a thumbs up if you liked it. Leave any questions down below and I will chat with you in the comments. I'll see you guys later. Bye. Okay, so because I use a high-end foundation...